随着中国软件行业的这个兴旺发展呢，我们看到了越来越多的这个源自中国的高质量开源软件进入到我们雷达的视野，然后正在逐渐成为全世界程序员的选择。
One of the reasons we're seeing so much open source from China is a mental shift in the way they perceive source code. Companies were previously concerned about protecting their intellectual property, and they didn't want to participate in open source. But now they see the power building up in the ecosystem around open source projects like Docker, Kubernetes, and OpenShift. Big open source projects like that have been a big shock to the system for Chinese companies, and they have seen that there is another way. You don't have to lock in, you can build an ecosystem. As long as you keep influence on the community, you can still control the IP. So this mental shift has been a really big positive influence for Chinese companies to participate in open source.
然后当谈到中国的开源软件的时候，大家可能都会想一想，那么这个东西是不是仅仅是国外一些开源软件的中国替代品呢？那么实际上我们看到并不是这样的情况。我们发现在中国现在的这个创新市场上面正如此蓬勃发展，我们有很多这种本土的这种原创的这样一些创新体现在我们的开源项目中。
China open source projects featured on this edition of the radar include Atlas and Beehive. These are Android and iOS frameworks from Alibaba. They allow better modularization within an application, and they can help distributed or remote teams collaborate better. They let you dynamically assemble isolated modules into a single coherent application. There are a number of companies in China who are contributing to open source. In particular, we'd mention Alibaba, Baidu, Huawei, and Tencent, but there are many others. A common approach is to have a specific page on the corporate website promoting open source, or a core space on GitHub where you can find their stuff.
我们想对英语世界的开发者讲，那么请你们更多的关注源自中国的开源项目，那么它里面可能会有一些你们意想不到的创新。我们想对这个中国市场上从事开源项目开发的成员讲，你们干得非常棒。